To make art in Desmos, we can begin with many of the same equations you may recognize from math class. Here, we're going to explore how inequalities can be used to restrict where our lines and curves appear and to generate shaded regions in our graphs. We have a few equations graphed here in the 2D graphing calculator, which we will use to represent our strategies. To start, let's focus on this first equation of a line, which is written in slope-intercept form with a slope of -1/2 and a y-intercept of -2. It is often beneficial to only show a specific region of a graph. In Desmos, we can use restrictions, represented by curly brackets and inequalities at the end of an expression. If we add x < 2 on the end of this expression in curly brackets, the line is now only displayed for the domain of x values that are < 2, shown as a dead end. We can modify this again to y values between -4 and 0, which is restricting the range of our function. Removing those brackets at the end, we can see another application of inequalities. Currently, this line represents only the x and y coordinates that satisfy this equation exactly, where the y values are equal to -1/2 times the x value -2. By changing this to a less than symbol, we now see the shaded region containing all the points whose y values are less than that expression of x values. The dotted line is used for less than, but if we change it to less than or equal to, the line turns solid, just by typing equals when your cursor is placed after the less than symbol. We can also shade above this expression by using a greater than symbol. Looking at our curving sine function next, we can use this same strategy to shade below this function with a less than or equal to symbol. Notice how where our two shaded regions overlap, we see a darker shading representing their intersection. Just like we use curly brackets after our function to restrict where it appeared, we can use that same notation to visualize this region of intersection. By putting our first inequality expression in brackets after our second expression, we are visualizing the shaded region that is both above our line and below our sine curve. Shading works the same for our last two expressions, even though they aren't functions of x. For the sideways parabola, we can shade to the right or left of the curve using an inequality to indicate the region of x values greater than or less than our expression of y values. For this last circle, this represents the set of points that are all 4 units away from the origin. If we use an inequality here, we can visualize the region more than 4 or less than 4 units from the origin. While this is already fun design, our last challenge is to shade in only the region they all have in common. As we saw earlier, one strategy is to add each of these expressions as a bracketed restriction after one of the functions. If we take the first line inequality to begin with, we can copy each of the other expressions as restrictions and see how that displays the intersection of all those regions. In many cases, this strategy works perfectly. However, there are also cases, as your graph gets more complicated, where compounding all these inequalities can get some choppiness in how the region is rendered. When we have multiple restrictions, it means that the calculator has to do a lot more work to figure out where it should be shading, and it may misrepresent regions. Let's look at one clever strategy for shading more complex intersections. As these are all algebraic expressions, we can first rearrange them to get them to have a 0 on one side. For our sine curve, if we subtract y from both sides, we have an equivalent expression with an equivalent graph, where 0 is less than this expression of x and y. That is, our shaded region represents all the points where this expression is positive. For our sideways parabola, we can subtract x from both sides, so we are again left with a 0 on the left side and that same less than inequality. We are shading the region where all the points, x, y, are positive when plugged into this expression. When we come down to the circle equation, in order to keep 0 on the left side, we can subtract the whole expression of x² + y² from 4². Now for the final line, notice how the inequality is currently greater than or equal to. We will first flip this around, rewriting our inequality as a less than or equal to, and then again subtract our expression of x from y to get 0 on the left side. Now we have 4 inequalities, and each of these represent a region where 0 is less than or equal to an expression of x and y. That is, we want the region where all of these expressions are positive. If there is a point that satisfies all of these inequalities, then even the smallest value you get when plugging it into the 4 expressions should still be positive. To calculate this, we can use the min function, representing the minimum value of a given set of numbers or expressions. If we write 0 is less than or equal to the min of each of these 4 expressions, separated by commas, it will show that region where every expression of x and y is positive. We can't wait to see how you use restrictions and shading with inequalities in your next Desmos art creation.